And welcome to Ubuntu. This is Daniel Hickenbytes with another video for you. It's been a while, but we're going to be showing you the first of several videos involving Linux Ubuntu. Linux is the alternative to Windows and the Mac. Windows has been the majority of the market share for a long time, and Mac is 9% currently at this time market share, and Linux is way down at the bottom somewhere, but they are coming up, and as product support is becoming more widely available, we are getting a bit more market share and more people starting to experiment with this. So here's a video on how it looks and works, so that if you're considering maybe switching over to a Mac from a PC, you might want to look at Linux for a few reasons. So we'll show you here. When you first turn it on, you got your desktop. It looks the same as a Windows desktop even, and you can have icons and shortcuts on there. We've got a few program shortcuts and icons on the left side where you can find applications and files, and then shortcuts to programs. A software center where you can actually download software, and so on. Through the dash home, it makes it easy to just type in the name of the program that you're looking for, or you can search based on category and start going through this way to find the programs that you're looking for. You can also search for files specifically, music, and everything in general. The folder structure is through your home folder, and this is where you'll see all your documents and downloads, music, and so on. And the menus at the top, similar to a Mac, where the menu up here at the top will change depending on what the program is that you have open at that time. So let's get into before we get to the presentation software, there's your other menu shortcuts here, depending, this is a laptop, so it's got a battery showing, and the wireless, and sound, calendar, and time, account settings, and if you want to shut down the computer, that's where that is currently in this particular version of Ubuntu 11.10. And let's go right into this presentation software I created for you guys, and we'll start the show. And this is equivalent to Microsoft's PowerPoint, which is very popular, but it's using the OpenOffice version, or not OpenOffice, that's a name of the software, which is also open source, but this is Libre, and you wouldn't know the difference if I didn't tell you, probably. Anyway, the Ubuntu desktop 11.10 we're using, similar to the Mac with the menus as I just mentioned, and it's really good if this is for personal use, that you're looking at getting into Ubuntu or Linux, of any version of Linux, or are many versions of Linux. The Ubuntu may be a very good alternative for you guys. And if you're using this for business use, you might not want to jump on it too quickly. You're going to want to research the programs that you're wanting to run on it and make sure that they're compatible. And so that's some of the things with the downfalls. Great for personal, but for as far as business goes, it's not compatible with all the programs yet. Although with cloud-based computing becoming more and more popular, it's not going to be as much of an issue, because all you need is access to the internet, which is very easy, and you've got everything you need. So eventually switching to Ubuntu for business won't be an issue either. Not as many technicians available for support on this yet, as you can probably guess, because Windows is the majority. You see all kinds of people and kids working out of their basement that say they can support Windows. Even less people can support Mac, because there are not as many market share, and then even less again for Linux. And you would have to get used to some software that is the new compatible alternative to Windows-based software. And it's basically going to be the same difference if you were considering switching to a Mac. You get to learn their stuff anyway. So if you go to Linux, then you can make use of some of the benefits, which we will get into now. The operating system is free. That's the biggest thing right there. If you were to purchase Windows by itself, it's about $150. Mac, they've got their various versions of their OS as well. And with the Linux, it is free and will always be free. If you want to find out why, you can read more about it on their website. I'll show you later. And the operating system can run on Windows type hardware, which means you've got more variety to choose from, and it's a whole lot cheaper because it can be from any manufacturer of hardware, not like the Mac where you have to use Apple hardware to run the Apple operating system and everything's Apple. So you can use anything you want, and because of its structure, it's built on Unix, which is what Apple is built on, and that was the initial computers that we even worked with when I was growing up. Even was Ubuntu or was Unix, not Ubuntu, Unix, which is where they come up with Linux now, is a Windows-looking GUI interface for Unix. So it's a lot more secure than and stable than what the Windows is based on the old DOS system. Tons of free software available, easy to access, and you can network with Windows computers, so file sharing, printer sharing, not as big of an issue, although there may be some tweaking in that involved. And you can dual boot between Windows and Linux, so if you want to have Windows in your back pocket without having another computer on standby, you can set it up so when you turn the computer on, it gives you two choices. Do you want to boot up into Linux or do you want to boot up into Windows? And you can also run a Windows inside of Linux, so if there are certain programs that just only run in Windows, instead of dual booting and you have to reboot, shut down Linux, turn it back on again to go into Windows just to run that program. You can run a virtual Windows within the Linux and then run that software inside the virtual Windows. So you can still get access to that program using a virtual Windows without having to shut down your Linux computer and closing all the other programs and files you have open inside of Linux. So that's pretty much the pros and cons of Ubuntu here. And I showed you the menu structures here. And getting online, everything is internet is internet. Email can be web-based, so you can get on there. Everything else is virtually web-based now. So all you need is access to the internet, and you can do everything. And there's a lot of stuff that you're gonna want to run on the computer. And for every program that's out there, there's just about a couple of alternatives that are free that you can download and that will work inside of Linux. You can check out linux.com here and read a lot more about Linux, or go straight to ubuntu.com and find out about Ubuntu, which is one of many versions of Linux available on the market. And my name's Daniel with Twin Bytes, and find out more about me, check out www.twinbytes.ca, and I'll be back again later with some more on Ubuntu. All right, thanks a lot, guys. Take care. See you later.